Hello guys, this is Lavanya from Unique Technologies. This video about how to create your own new Blink 2.0 account and your own templates. Your own template in Blink 2.0. This is very new one. And for that, first you have to type Blink on your Chrome or Firefox. After that, you have to click the first link on Blink IoT platform. On that, you have to click on the login. So we are not going to login, so we have to create the new account. So for that, you have to log in any mail ID. I am using projectecan@gmail.com. After that, you'll receive one welcome message from Blink. Using that link only, you have to create your password. I'm creating my password with strong captchas, like I'm using projectecan. At 123, you have to use 8 symbols, like capital letter and small letters and symbols. So I am creating just my own password. After that, you have to create your profile name. Profile name in this sense, your project name. So I am using ecan. So that is my project. After that, you have to create your own template. So after that, creating the template only, you'll receive the template ID and your own data stream name. You have to create the new template name. This is a template name only. So I'm using ecan for this. I'm using the hardware for ecan, ESP8266. Connection type, it's Wi-Fi. After giving all your parameters, your own template ID and Blink account creator, after that, you have to click on save. Next, we are not going to change any data in metadata. We have to create the data streams alone. For data streams, I have to click the virtual pin because I am using the sensor. I am going to upload the sensor values here. So I am click on that virtual pin, and that we have to give like name. Name means it's a visible one for label. And after that, I am creating the V0 and data type is integer. And units, like minimum and maximum values, we have to give. We are going to using the analog sensor. So I am using a minimum value as 0 and maximum value as 800. If I am going to use digital pin, means minimum value 0 and maximum value 1. So depends upon the sensors, I can alter these new streams. And after that, I'm not going to change anything in events. I have to create the web dashboard. On that web dashboard, I have to click label. Label in the sense is it's just displaying the values. For example, gas value, it's 80, 90, up to 800, I can get it. And for the title also, I'm going to use same gas. So on that gas, I'm going to use virtual pin V0. It's a first pin. So next, I need a chart. So if you need any charts or map or modules, you can properly you can arrange it. After that, I'm taking the chart name, it's gas, and I have to enable the x-axis, y-axis and zoom options, and I can change the color values also. It's like plotting colors. So after enabling all the pins, like so, y-axis, auto scale and enabling zoom, your graph will appear here. So I have to change my chart settings. So once I done the chart settings, I can close that. And you have to save for each and every data, like metadata and events, data streams, all those things you have to save. And mobile dashboard, finally it's a mobile dashboard. On that mobile dashboard, you have to edit, like it's like you have to connect your mobile through Blink IoT. So you can access on your PC also and mobile also, okay? So this is your own Blink 2.0. Thank you guys.